There have been at least a dozen Jewish rabbis that have said the Messiah is on earth now. He's been identified. He is soon going to make himself known. In the Jewish mindset, for the Messiah to arrive, you can't think of him like we think of Messiah. We think of Messiah after the model of Jesus. He's the Son of God, divine birth, all of that. That's not the way the Jews look at the Messiah. They're looking for a king. They're looking for a political leader. As a matter of fact, Messiah to them means the anointed one, and it goes back to the ancient days when they would anoint a king and recognize him as this is the man that God sent. I'm not saying that they think he is the Messiah. What I actually think is that most of the rabbis there think he's John the Baptist and the Messiah is about to appear. He's the forerunner. He's the guy that's going to start the message in the wilderness, and the Messiah is going to come in on his heels. They too believe that the Messiah is about to appear. We would say the second coming is about to happen, and so we need the temple service. We need to get back into Israel, the Messiah. Now, why are they saying that? They have identified somebody. I mean, there could be a few rabbis there that think he's the Messiah. The smart ones in Israel are looking at him right now. They're saying he is God's, what we would call John the Baptist. He is God's messenger. When he takes over in January, there is a 5777 countdown to the appearance of the Messiah, and something could happen overnight that could lead to the reconstruction of the temple.
A lot of the scholars that I've spoken to talk about how the building of this next temple is really going to bring peace to Israel and to bring safety from all her enemies. And so in that way, I can see that any maybe leader that would be raised up or somebody that would be able to bring the nations together, especially those who might align with Israel, that there might be some agreement that the temple could exist there and this person could be set up in the temple. What we know is that make a peace agreement.
Matthew Miller, better known by his Hebrew stage name Matityahu, burst onto the music scene in 2004 as something of a novelty. An observant Orthodox Jew who sang reggae songs about his faith. He says his music is a reflection of his spirituality. And he got involved with the Hasidic Chabad Lubavitch movement. Not only got involved, he says, but jumped into it full force. Matityahu moved to Crown Heights, Brooklyn, where the Chabad Lubavitch movement is headquartered. And he entered a yeshiva, where he spent his weekdays in intensive study of the Torah. He says he was inspired by the beauty he found in the text. Matityahu began performing those songs and became a sensation, the reggae singer with the Orthodox black hat and coat. The religious themes in his lyrics were numerous and overt. His top 40 hit, King Without a Crown, incorporates Chabad's belief that the coming of the Messiah, Moshiach, is near. The song's chorus is explicit, "I want Moshiach now."
I give myself to you from the essence of my being, and I sing to my God songs of love and healing. I want Mashiach now.
You want to tell the Rebbe the words of the new song that we're singing with Mashiach, right? So I'm just going to read them. Am Yisrael, have no fear. Mashiach will be here this year. We want Mashiach now. We don't want to wait. Okay?
We won't see us now. 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 gemacht. Das haben die Kinder von früher gemacht. Da besser nicht durch den Mugiot. Aber ich weiß nicht, ob Zivis Hashem rein.
Und ich wollte nicht mehr zu dir sein, sondern doch nicht stark zu sein, besser nicht dieser Schlicht.
Wer besorgt mal gut gewünscht, Jörg?
Sein Gesicht. Alle Kinder da.
Das haben die Jungen von Sidney. Das haben sie gemacht, hat der gemacht. Und dann besser nicht durch Hashem, die hat die Rambam. Das haben wir dann von Rebbe. Er ist der, was hat das gemacht, und der Jungen hat geholfen.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for your gift.
Thank you.
מעניק לך את זה כשי לחג החנוכה,
yeah.
ואני מקווה שבית המקדש ייבנה במהרה בימינו, ושזה יישאר רק בגדר של מדגם.
בקרוב ממש, זה העיקר. מה שישראל לאחרונה, נמצא מתקצו כמה עניינים.
תפקו כמה.
מה שלא יראות, וגם מה צריך שעדיין משאיר ליבו. אז הייתה של מה שהוא, ומה הביאתו.
ועושים, עושים.
הכניזה שהיא מספיק, כאילו שהיום כבר... שוד, כמה שוד, בגיל עדיין ליבו. אבל יש את כמה שוד, שעות, אבל יש להשתדל גם היום.
Before the end time comes, there'll be a woman that'll be a great ruler in this nation. She'll either be president or something on that order, some great woman. And at that time, automobiles, just before the coming of the Lord, will be in the shape of an egg.
This is on tape two. A powerful woman, great woman. She'll either be president or it'll be a woman representing the Catholic Church, which I think it is. Will take over here someday, and she'll rule this country. This nation is a woman's nation. In 1933, this is a woman's nation. It's the number 13. It appears in the 13th chapter of Revelation. It's 13 stars, 13 stripes, 13. Everything's a 13. Everything is woman, and remember, thus saith the Lord. There'll be a woman rule for the end time. She'll either be president, vice president, or it'll be the Catholic Church as a woman. I've seen her, a great woman. The nation bowed to her. It'll be one before the end time. Thus saith the Lord. Write it down and find out, you young people, if it happens. If it isn't, I'm a false prophet.
There'll be a woman that'll be a great ruler in this nation. She'll either be president or something on that order, some great woman. And at that time, automobiles, just before the coming of the Lord, will be in the shape of an egg.
This is on tape two. A powerful woman, great woman. She'll either be president or it'll be a woman representing the Catholic Church, which I think it is. We'll take over here someday. And she'll rule this country. This nation is a woman's nation. In 1933, this is a woman's nation. It's the number 13. It appears in the 13th chapter of Revelation. It's 13 stars, 13 stripes, 13. Everything's a 13. Everything is woman. And remember, thus saith the Lord. There'll be a woman rule for the end time. She'll either be president, vice president, or it'll be the Catholic Church as a woman. I've seen her, a great woman. The nation bowed to her. It'll be one before the end time. Thus saith the Lord. Write it down and find out, you young people, if it happens. If it isn't, I'm a false prophet.
big giant round area with 13 thrones encircling this area. And the 13th throne was empty. The 12th throne is where the head Illuminati members sat. And the previous 11 thrones were occupied by the dead bodies of previous heads of the Illuminati. So he was, in her telling, she said that we were at the end of time, and that this was the final, this Illuminati was in charge now, that Illuminati guy, head guy, whatever of course she called him, the master, she called him the master, that he was the last one before the final one would be Christ, he was going to sit in the empty 13th throne.